Hello everybody and welcome to another Anime Thoughts and Opinions video. I don't know how I'm going to do this one. This one's going to be a little weird, weirder than normal. It's probably going to be rather short, especially, I mean, normally some of them can be short. Usually they're rather long, even for short-ass things. This one is 13 episodes for the season, the first season, so normally that would be like a 35-minute to an hour-plus long thoughts and opinions, but I don't really think it's going to last that long this time, because I'm not really going to be talking about the nitty-gritty of the show, which like I usually do, and instead I'm just going to be talking about what I liked and didn't like. There's no real reason as to why I've rushed it so much, but I honestly don't have much to say, so there's not much to really talk about. Anyways, before we get into it, this is my next This is my next random anime, which means it's one that was pulled from the pool. This was recommended to me twice in total, and it was originally recommended to me by some Dingleberry on Discord, for which we did co-op this series. So we have since finished it today, woke up. I was going to watch it last night, but unfortunately I got too tired and bored and ended up going to sleep, and we just watched it today. Finished it a couple hours ago. We've just been kind of faffing around, and now I'm finally getting around to doing the video. So I've already done my analyst entry and everything like that. Okay, I've got my little piece of paper here, which has a couple notes on it that I can go ahead and talk about. But let me get the usual disclaimers out of the way, first and foremost. This is not a professional review or a detailed one. It's more or less just a ramble video where I do technically review it, usually, but it's more or less just me talking about my thoughts and opinions and experiences that I had while watching it. On top of that, that means because I don't follow a script or anything like that, there's no editing in this video. This is more or less like something that you'd probably rather listen to rather than watch, and expect me to possibly repeat myself or forget to say something. Because of that, if there is something I don't talk about in this video that you wanted to hear my opinions on, you can always post in the comments section a question or something relating to the anime, and I'll talk to you down there. Also, in the description you will find various links. Link number one will be to my analyst. If you are curious to keep track of any and all of my anime statistics, look at my favorite characters list, favorite anime list, favorite staff list, and various other things. You don't have to follow me on there, that's always your choice. Same goes for Twitter. Twitter I post, usually, sneak peeks to the anime I'll be talking about next and various other updates and posts. You'll also be able to find a link to my anime thoughts and reviews YouTube playlist down there, so you can see the chronological list of every single thoughts and opinions video I've done, all organized into one area for those of you that would like to watch them in order, since I don't actually number these episodes. And there'll probably be some other shit down there, but whatever. And don't forget, you can always feel free to recommend and suggest new anime to me in the comment section. All suggestions, with the exceptions of Gundam, ongoing series, and a couple other things, like, for example, if they're not actually on analyst, they will all go onto my list and all be thrown into the bowl. Which I don't know why I call it a bowl, because it's technically not a bowl, but whatever. Anyways, moving on. So, Overlord, what is this? I don't know. Well, I didn't know going into it, so it was, how do I put this? Normally, I would have considered this a blind anime, where... And basically what that means, in case you haven't watched any of my previous episodes, a blind anime is one that I go into without knowing anything about. So I go into it with zero expectations. However, I did know a little bit about this, specifically that it contained fantasy elements, so I went into this expecting a fantasy anime, which you get, so okay. Unfortunately though, and I think this is what's going to come as a bit of a disappointment to people that were expecting to hear me like gush over this, I really did not enjoy this anime, and I have a reason for that. I think a good enough idea as to why. So note that the rating I gave to it on analyst, which does look pretty harsh because it is a low 6.8 rating, which I don't give many sixes that often. Usually the sixes I give these days are towards OVAs or things like that, not an entire series. So why didn't I enjoy it as much? Well, I kind of found a majority of it boring. And the reason for that is, the only idea that I can come up with isn't because Overlord is bad or anything. Obviously not. I still enjoyed watching it. I mean, I co-opted it, and that was perfectly fine. And there was a lot of elements that I did like, which we're going to talk about. But I think it's sort of the idea that this is... it's not in the same genre style, but it is a mixed fantasy genre, which means basically you have a real world connected to a fantasy world, though it's different here. I think any and all of my opinions have been altered because I've seen Gate. And because I love Gate so much, I go into other fantasy anime now expecting it to be just as good, and I end up being disappointed in return. Blame Gate. So, what exactly did I not like about Overlord so much that made me put it so low on the list? Well, really, it's just I wasn't really interested at all throughout most of it. There's funny scenes and there's good gory scenes, you know, and violence and the battle scenes are top notch. So that's something that is really good. But the rest of it, I wasn't really involved. Normally, if I get interested in an anime like this, I become interested and everything these characters do, I'm always invested in. And I'm always interested in. Even if they're doing boring shit like eating at a table or something, that's interesting to me if I'm invested. This is how I was towards Gate. This is not how I was towards Overlord. The first main thing that I actually didn't really like was the idea of this being a... I forgot what it's called. I think it's DMMO RPG. Essentially, it's this crazy... Now, this would be badass if we had this in real life. But essentially, it's a virtual reality where you're actually there, but in a video game. So it's a full hands-on RPG, MMO, which is totally badass. For some reason, I don't like this. However... if that were the whole thing, I probably would have put this even lower on the list. But they actually do something a little bit more unique that I wasn't expecting. So one of the main story turning points is rather early on, like within the first or second episode, I think. Maybe even been as early as episode one. The servers are supposed to be shutting down. And so our main character and all of his friends, like all of his friends log out. And you know, he stays behind. He's going to stay until the very end. Till the server shut down, and then the moment the server shut down, it starts over. But everything's different. So there are elements that have changed, things that are different, like NPCs are able to make their own decisions and they smell, and he's able to interact with the world even more. And so I guess the idea is, it's never explained, and I don't know if this is ever explained in the future seasons, but it's never explained in season one, I guess the idea is that something fucked up and he is now literally stuck in a real world and not an MMO world anymore. However, they keep up the MMO idea by not only does him, the player, but also everyone else in the world use MMORPG terminology. And some of that is really clever and some of it is funny a lot, but some of it is annoying to me. Like some of it kind of takes me out of the mood. And even though I guess the deaths here, like in a normal MMO, if you died, it wouldn't matter. You just, you know, you'd come back, you'd respawn or whatever, or the enemies would respawn or whatever. There wouldn't be any meaningful deaths. But here, I think deaths are a lot more open, which is probably why they're a lot more of a threat, which is probably why I didn't dislike this as much, since I realized that there's actually shit at stake. But even then, I was never on edge towards any of the characters, so I did not become attached to any of the characters as of yet. I mean, just for those of you that want to know, I did put season 2 on the list now, so it is open for moving on to. It's just not something I'm going to move to myself right now because I'm not interested in doing so. But I never became attached to any of the characters in a way where, like, if they were to become hurt or if, you know, injured, or if they were to die and actually be dead, I wouldn't feel anything. I don't even think I would tear up that much. That's just how unattached to any of these characters I were. That's not to say, however, that the characters are boring, because most of the characters are actually really fun to watch. So, I don't know. That's why I said this is going to be a weird episode to make, because I'm so torn apart on this. I don't know whether to like it or whether to dislike it. And I know I'm in the minority on that, because I have since gone back and looked at the analyst ratings for this, and a majority are in the 70s and 80s for ratings. and seeing that I put it in the 60s, I'm definitely in the minority on that. But I still can't help myself in thinking, I don't know why I didn't really enjoy this all that much. I was just kind of bored. So I think I pretty much got a lot of what I didn't like out of the way. It's just that I wasn't interested at all for some reason. And that's weird because I love this fantasy shit, and I love the medieval ages, and seeing that kind of stuff mixed in with the fantasy. And there's some badass scenes in here. Like, you got skeletal dragons, which is really, really badass, and they've got really good CG. You know, and all that kind of stuff is great. So there's a lot that I do like and I do appreciate, which is what we're going to talk about now. For example, well, let's talk about the CGI. Now, I'm going to immediately compare this to various other anime that have either a lot of CG or minimum CG. Now, this is not in the same boat as, like, Space Battleship Yamato, where you or Girls on Panzer, where you have vehicular CGI. That's different. Here you have character and or beast CGI, and that is so easy to fuck up. Not only have anime like Girls on Panzer done a CGI player, a CGI character model, which looks like a player model from the first PlayStation era, and it looks sticks out like a sore thumb and looks ugly as hell, but then you've also got anime like the Berserk films, which my biggest complaint with those, because I never did a thoughts and opinions video on those, mind you, this was before I started doing these videos, my biggest issue with those films were that the CG was awful. And they kept switching between 2D and 3D in the same scene, and it was really bad in my opinion. Though the fight scenes and battle scenes and, you know, gore and everything were still top notch. I feel like that's sort of the same way here, only it's not as bad. So you get to see like CG skeletons, like the skeletal dragons I mentioned earlier. But you don't always see it. So normally, I would have expected anybody in any suit of armor to automatically be CG. That's not the case here. However, I did notice they did that dumb thing Berserk did again. And yes, I hate it just as much here as I did there. For some bizarre reason, half the scenes with horses and horse riders are CG. And then half the other time, they're 2D. What is the fucking point in animating them in CG and then animating them in 2D? Just animate them in one or the other. Don't flip back and forth. That's something that was so just, if you stuck with CG, even if it looked bad, I'd get used to it, and therefore I'd be able to adapt to it over time. But when they keep flipping back and forth, I notice it every time. And if I were to get used to it, nope, now it's back to normal. Now it's back to CG. Now it's back to 2D. Just make up your fucking mind. That bugged me a lot. That is how much CG characters piss me off in anime, because it's super easy to fuck up. However, what about the good CG? Well, a lot of the big beasts have CG, like, for example, the skeletal dragons. These, I don't think, are too bad. Now, they're nothing groundbreaking, but they're not ugly. They look good. They look really good, actually. The lighting and everything on them, the textures and the detail actually looks really good. So, therefore, I liked seeing those on the screen, and I would not have been opposed to seeing more of them. So, good. Thumbs up there. It's definitely, overall, the CG is not bad. So overall, the CG is something I can deal with. And it's definitely something that I don't think should be shit on like I normally do when it comes to that sort of stuff. And I guess we'll take that same thing to talk about the art style and the animation. So the animation is the typical thing, so there's nothing really groundbreaking to talk about in animation regard. The art style, though, once again, because it's a fantasy-style anime, everything is so ridiculously colorful, and that's a good thing. That's a plus. I love how everything has such a vibrant color. Even the dark colors are vibrant somehow. That's good. That seems to be in any of these genre of anime I watch. That's always the case, and I love that a lot. Now, the art style in terms of like character facial animations can sometimes be a little awkward, specifically when characters are either lovey-dovey or they're insane and creepy. Some of them I just couldn't get my mind around, specifically the lovey-dovey facial expressions. For some reason, I just didn't find them all that enjoyable. But as a whole, everything there is perfectly fine, and those got pretty high ratings from me. Now, let's talk about, since I didn't really talk about the story all that much, besides the whole premise, which I'm not going to really, But let's talk about the fight scenes. So throughout about 80% of this anime, like I said, I was uninterested and bored. I did actually start to gain an interest in the last two episodes. So in the last couple episodes of the series, they really start to kick it off. And the battles are tense and suspenseful, and they're definitely a lot more enjoyable to watch. Now, the anime ends with a showdown between two characters, and normally, if you spend your entire time watching an anime and there's some big showdown at the end, it's usually, even if it's badass, it usually ends the same way, right? It's usually always a couple minutes. It's a couple minutes, maybe 10 minutes if you're lucky, of a battle, and then it's over. Well, not in this. This, it takes like a full episode plus half of another episode for the battle to end. And the battle itself is actually really enjoyable. And even there, the whole, you know, the MMO terminology didn't bother me. There, it was actually fine. And I was perfectly okay with it. If the rest of the show had shit that interested me like that, and I'm not saying that it has to have action. I've already stated a million times that I can sit and fall in love with people sitting at a table talking or eating food. For some reason, I just wasn't interested in any of the other time I watched this. But the ending, that is the shit. If there was more of that, I would have become so much more interested and attached to characters. So I don't know if season 2 improves upon any of this or not. If it doesn't, I'm probably really going to lose interest in this series as a whole. If it does gain my interest, I can always rewatch the first season in the future with a new opinion and be able to judge it accordingly. Because I've said this before, I don't say it all the time nowadays, but I'll mention it again for those of you that don't know, but just because I've got some sort of rating going, that isn't always my finalized opinion on an anime. 6.8? Yeah, pretty low. Didn't enjoy it? Yeah, okay, fair enough. But that still doesn't mean that I'll enjoy it less than something that's rated higher, and that doesn't mean that that rating can change over time. I've had a couple anime now that have had ratings change, for better or for worse. It just depends whether I have to rewatch it or whether I just have to let some time pass and think about it more. We'll have to see. And any edits to ratings that I give are always posted in my analyst. I will always, in the notes section, post edit, you know, update edit, rating edit, and then I'll have a date for when it was edited and what it was and then what it went to, whether it went up or dropped. So that's something that you can keep track of there as well. So one of the great things I liked about the final battle itself was the main character's use of his guildmate's items, essentially. So this was really cool because basically everybody has their own specific items, weapons, armor, whatever it may be, right? When you're playing MMOs. I'm just talking now. When you get up high enough to that stage where you're maxed out and you're OP as fuck like they are in this fucking anime, you usually end up settling with an armor set or a weapon or, you know, an item set that you grow attached to and you use forever. That's something I really like here. And he uses, during this final battle, without spoiling like characters or anything like that, he uses items from his, I don't know if I should say like missing guildmates, because they're not logged in and thus they're not transported to this world with him. So it's really awkward, but I doubt they're dead, and I don't really know if they're gone altogether or not, because there's some hints that I picked up on. But He has these wooden sticks, he breaks them, and he gets their item, he switches to their item. I thought that was really cool. I thought that was a really unique element to the battle. That was something I really liked. Now when it came to and the battle maids, that's probably another one of the reasons why this anime isn't lower on my rating list, because if you put a maid, if you give me an armored maid, literally, and a maid outfit that has armor on it, I will get such an erection. Why? Well, I'll tell you two reasons, but you're about to get on two of my fetishes. Fetish number one, I am attracted to female in plate armor, and I am very much attracted to females in maid outfits. You combine the two, you've got yourself one huge erection. So the battle maids are a badass and awesome. They can stand on me whenever they want. Anyways, okay, moving on. So that's it. That's the gist. That's why this is a short-ass video. And I'm really sorry if I stepped on anyone's toes with this. I don't mean to. Keep in mind, I don't hate this anime or anything. I think it's just something that I wasn't ready for. and because I just watched Gate, you know, a couple weeks ago, and that's still going to affect my opinion on fantasy anime for right now. So it's possible that I should just give it a little bit of time, and maybe I'll rewatch Overlord in the near future, you know, in a month or two, or watch season two or something like that. Whenever I come around to getting to that, I could just pull it out of the bowl, of course. And we'll see if I feel the same way. If I don't, then I can always update everything. Okay, so keep in mind that this isn't always just my finalized opinion. There's just a few things that I wasn't attached to, and for some reason I didn't find it all that much fun to watch. And I don't know, whatever. So, yeah. There's still, of course, there's plenty of shit from this anime I didn't talk about in this video, which is why I said you can always post in the comment section if there's something in particular you want to hear me talk about. And on top of that, that means the next anime that I'm watching is one that I've chosen by choice, and I have chosen that by choice. It's already been chosen. I had a bit of issue trying to figure out what one I wanted to watch next, but I just picked one that sounded interesting, and I have some expectations going into it. So you can expect to see that one. It's very soon. It's only 11 episodes in length. You may even see it in the next, like, 5 hours. If not, it will be sometime tomorrow, but I'm thinking about maybe marathoning it before I go to sleep. I haven't decided yet or not. And then after that, it's another random. And then after that, I have already decided what the next anime I'm going to watch is by choice, unless I happen to pull it from the random list. And that one is actually one I'm looking forward to quite a bit. So we'll find out. Anyways, guys, this was a bit of a painful one to make because I knew that it wasn't going to be that fun to make a video on. And I know that I'm probably going to get a little bit of anger thrown towards me, and I totally understand that. So we can talk about it in the comments section later, but for now, guys, I'm going to bring this one to an end. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next Anime Thoughts and Opinions.